Hi everyone, myself Supriya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss the space requirement in relation to the human body. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, the learner will be able to impart the knowledge of space required in relation to the human body. A body is a physical being that occupies the space and the time beyond the spatial constitution. So it deals with the anthropometry. It is the science which deals with the measurement of the human body. It is the system. It deals with the systematic measurements of the human, the weight, the surface area, and the fittings, the standing versus the sitting height. This the body and the space. Here you can see that the space and the time, the space and the body, it is somewhat the two sides of a same coin. So we should understand our body, and so that we can able to design the space required for our body. So when we understand our body, then only we can design the space required for that. So here you can see the body dimensions. So in general, the anthropometric data, it is divided into two types. The one is the structural anthropometric data and second is the functional. So in the structural, these are the measurements of the bodily dimensions that are in the fixed positions. And next you have the functional anthropometric data, which deals with the body measurements or the bodily dimensions in the relation to the motions, that is when the movement is there. So that comes under the functional anthropometric data. So there are anthropometric data, actually it is important in the design, such that you can easily determine the body dimensions and you can determine the space requirement and determine the what principle is to be applied, and also the defining the equipments and the facilities to be used. Here you can see in this example that a person is using the lock system, that is the handle. So the handle of the door handle, it should be at a it should not be more than the highest standing height or the highest standing knuckle height in a population, so that all the users can easily open the can easily handle the door. Here you can see that this is a person sitting on a chair, and a width here is the space left to the side. That means the width of the chair should be so designed, or should be narrower than the person, or width of the chair must be narrower than the highest hip breadth of the largest of the large woman or the man. So the doorway, this is the doorway, or the height of the doorway, the height of the doorway should be such that the tallest person can easily accommodate in this. And also the allowance should be given for the shoes and the clothing also. And this is the person using the lock over here, the lock of the door. That is the height of the door, the height of the lock should be such that even the tallest person can use the lock, and it should be the vertical height of the, that means the height of the lock should be, the height of the lock should be such that it should be away from the reach of the person of a small person. It should be away from the reach of a small person. That means it should be at a height such that the tallest person can easily use the height. And here you can see that a person is sitting on the chair. That means the back, that is the height of the chair, and the width of the depth of the chair should be such that the height and the width of the chair should be such that it should not exceed the maximum height and the buttock knee length of the person. So let's see the computer workstation. What are the flexibilities over here? This is the depth of the chair. That is the height of the chair should be such that the person can easily have a comfortable seat. And even this position can be, or the height of the chair can be adjusted as per the users. And second is the depth of the chair, that is the height of the chair, where you can see that the lower level of the back of the person is rested over there. That means it should be at a comfortable height. And even the C is the angle of the keyboard and the I vane. It is adjusted in such a way that he easily uses the monitor without bending the person. He can easily see the vision of the monitor. And this is the height of the table. The height and the width of the table should be such that it should be at a comfortable reach. That means easily it should accommodate. And next is the height of the person or the height of the eyesight. It should be at a comfortable height so that you can easily have access. The tabletop should be such that the width is easily adjusted over there. And all these things comes under the anthropometry. Next is the body measurements in relation to the neutral position, and this is the awkward position. The neutral position that is in a standing position, and here you can see that just is spreading his legs, and this is the awkward position, that is the back flexion and the twisting about the waist, and here you can see that the lateral bending. So at what angle he is bending. So that is it comes under the space requirement. So these are the body measurements when a person is standing in a straight without any carrying any load over there. So in that case you can see that the center of gravity, it is at the elbow, and this is the line of the gravity, and the base of the support is fixed over there on the ground. And here in the second case you can see that the center combined, the line of the gravity, it is a combined, that is the center of gravity of the elbow and the line of the gravity, it is combined, and the load of the center of gravity, that is the laptop which is carrying it, creates the load which is created on the elbow, that is the center of gravity and the line of the gravity, the combined, it is lying at the elbow itself. And on the next example, here you can see that the combined center of gravity lies over waist, and next is the load center of the gravity. In this case you can see that the combined center of gravity, it is at the waist, and the load of the center of gravity, it is in the laptop which is carrying, and the base of the support is fixed over here. Next is the measurements in these cases. You can see that these are the cases which you can see the person sitting here in a comfortable position, resting with his lower back, and here is just taken a slight movement over here at some angle, and this is a person who is resting the one third of his body portion, and here it is in a sleeping position. So in all these cases you can see that what is the space required over here. So the width is maximum when he is sleeping, that is 2000, and when 2000 mm, and here you can see that this is the width. The width is minimum when he is sleeping, and the maximum when he is comfortable in a sitting position with his lower back. You can see that width is maximum. So this is the space required when he is sitting and when he is sleeping. So let's see the step measurements, how they are. So you can see that the measurements walking in step or marching, then you have the strolling, the maximum density. So what are the what is the space required in a cable railway and so on. So next is the a person is when he is operating, and this is the standing position. Next comes the these are the motions of these are the functional anthropometric data. What is the space required when they are doing actual motions? So as per that, the dimensions are given. So the space requirement with the luggage. So this is the space required. That is when he is in a single luggage, or when he is with the double luggage, so on. And when the two persons are occupying at one place itself. So what is the space occupied? Means without any touch in the luggage itself, you can see that how comfortably they are moving together. And you can see whereas the ladies with their purse and the luggage, what is the space requirement for that? So even you can see the person with an umbrella and the stick, and and the two persons with an umbrella and a stick, or only a person with a stick itself. So these are the dimensions given to that, and the space requirement in according to the human body. So this is the normal spacing given to you, and the spacing during the walking. So this is the total number of persons if you consider as 12, and the total area is 1.7. This is 1.7 into 1.875. The space area is 3.2 meters square. So the persons per square meter it is occupying as 12 divided by 3.2, it is 3.75. Whereas when the total persons during the walking, you can see the number of persons are 9. So the area will be 1.7 into 1.1 into 3 into 0.75. That is, the total area is 4.2 meters square. So the persons per square meter works out to be 9 divided by 4.2, that is 2.14. So this is the difference between the normal spacing and the spacing during the walking. So just pause your video for 2 seconds and try to give the answer for this. Which of the following anthropometric assessment which does not show much change in 1 to 4 years? The first, hope so you have got the answer. This is the right answer for that. These are the references. Thank you.